Lynn, what's your reaction to the recent studies that are saying that we don't have enough environmental and health information about fracking?
That we don't have enough? We have volumes and volumes of information from scientists and doctors such as Theo Colburn on the dangers of fracking to human health. I mean, there's study after study, and one of them, the preeminent Colorado study, states that whether your frack well is operating fine or not, the people living within a mile from it are experiencing birth defects, they're experiencing respiratory problems, they're exposed to cancer-causing chemicals, because these wells leak this air 24/7. It comes up through the wellhead, and there's nothing they can do about it, and it's coming up constantly, so that's endangering human health. That's just one study, but there are many, and you can go to psehealthyenergy.org, I think it is, on the net, Physicians, Scientists, and Engineers for Healthy Energy, and you can just see a compendium of all of those studies. And it would be good if people read these, because the mainstream media was not covering them, because the hydrofracturing industry was making sure to pay them, you know, for advertising so they could spread their propaganda, rather than you know, having these truthful studies printed. So there's plenty of resources out there.
Okay. Great. Thank you very much. And I'll include that website on the with the interview.